Hello guys, so today I want us to take a look at how you can be able to set up VPN. So I want us to look at PPTP VPN, the setup. This is really important when you have multiple sites, because definitely when you have multiple remote sites, these are sites that you need to be accessible. They need to be reachable at any time. And you should also be able to access them or reach them from whatever network you are in. You do not just have to be limited to reaching them when you're in your network. So basically what we have here, you can see I have two Mikrotik routers opened. So this is going to act as our core Mikrotik, where we are going to set up the PPTP VPN, set up the secrets, so that those same secrets, those credentials, we can deploy them to these other Mikrotik. So this is going actually to act as our remote site. So it's a pretty simple process to do. So the first thing that we'll need to do is come and create a pool of IPs. This is a pool of IPs where our clients, the remote sites, will now be assigned IPs from this particular pool. So we come to IP pool. We add an IP pool. We are going to name this probably as a PPTP pool. And we are going to assign a range of IPs here. 172.10.20.2 to 172.10.20.254. Apply. Okay. So basically, this is the range that the remote sites are going to be given when they connect as a PPPoE. PPTP client, sorry about that. So after that, we need to NAT this IP pool. So we come to IP firewall. Let me just expand this. NAT plus, this is going to be masquerade. And our source NAT address is going to be 172.10.20.0/24. Okay. Apply. Okay. So the next thing that you need to do, you now need to come to PPP. Then you need to come to the profile section. Then you now need to create a profile. So we are going to name this PPTP profile. And the local address is going to, let's get the local address from the PPTP pool. The remote address is also going to, let's get it from the PPTP pool as well. And that's it. Apply. Okay. So the next thing that we'll need to do, we'll need to now create some few other firewall rules that will enable PPTP to go through. So we need to come to IP firewall. Now this time we are going to go to filter rules. We are now going to add some few filter rules for the PPTP to actually work. So we come to add, and the chain here is going to be input chain, and the protocol we are going to use protocol, this is supposed to be GRE, and your in interface should be your one, or for my case it's going to be my ether one. Apply. Okay, so that is the first filter rule. We have one more filter rule to add. So we are going to say add. The chain is still going to be an input chain. And then after that, we are going to use TCP protocol. Yeah, that's it. And then we are going to add a port number here. This is the port number that is used by PPTP. That is 1723. And your interface here is either going to be your one or your ether one for my case. Apply. Okay. So with those two rules, the PPTP is supposed to work for you. Then now the next step that we go to, we now need to go to the secrets so that we can be able to add the users who are going to be authenticating or connecting to this PPTP service. So we are going to add. What name do we give it? We can give it, let's say, new user. We are going to say the password could be 12345. And it's important that you choose the service here. We are working with PPTP, so we are choosing the service to be PPTP. And the profile, it's going to be the profile that we generate, that we created. This is going to be PPTP profile. Okay, you apply that, and I need to not forget this because it's going to be usable somewhere. Okay, so once that is set, we are now done. Oh, sorry, we need to first of all come to the interface section. Then we need to set up PPTP server. So we are going to enable this. We are going to let everything else remain as it is. No, the default profile, we need to choose the PPTP profile. Yeah. Then you apply that. Okay. So basically that is all that you need to do from your main site. And now let's go to our remote site so that we give it these particular secrets and see if we can get a connection. So we are done with that. So we need to come to this. Let's enlarge on that. Oops, we are having a bit of a problem. Just let me fix that. New inbox. Yep, this is the guy that I want. I think I have no password here. Let's connect. Okay, let's enlarge on that. So let's do away with this. We do away with this. So what we now need to do, now remember, now this is now our second router, and this is now the remote site that we now want to configure. So all you need to do is now set up PPTP client on this. So to set up PPTP client, all you need to do is you come to interface, this drop down here, then scroll to where it says PPTP client. So maybe we can give it a name, or we can just let it be PPTP out one. Then the dial out. So our dial out is going to be the IP, the one IP of the first Mikrotik that we had, which is this. Let's try and pull it. So let's see, IP addresses. Yep, here it is. So we're just going to copy this. So it's going to connect to that, yeah. And our user, I think we said it's new user. And our password is 12345. So every other thing is supposed to remain as it is. So let's apply this and see if we get connected. Oop, yes, there we are. You see we are now connected, the status is connected, and you can see the IP that we've been assigned here. So when we come to this other, to our other router, and we come to active connections, you should be able to see us here. So user one, that's an active connection. You can see the caller ID where I'm calling, where the router is calling from, and this is the IP that has been assigned. So this router can now be accessible remotely using this IP. So we can also do the same setup for our laptop computer if that's what you would also want to use. So all you need to do is come to your network settings, click on open networks and internet settings. Then you need to come to VPN so that you can set up a new VPN connection. Then you say add a VPN connection. So our VPN provider definitely is the Windows inbuilt connection, and our service name is, you remember we had this somewhere, PPTP out one, and our address is the IP that we copied. This is 172.16.20.255. You remember where we got this from, right? This is from the first router, the Ether1 IP. Then our VPN type, you're going to choose PPTP. You're going to leave this as a username and password. And then our username here, we used, let's say, new user. And our password is 12345. So when you save this, it's supposed to connect. So let's test it out. So it's saved. We now need to come to that and say connect. Yep, it's connected. You can just see it's already popped up here. Here it is, and it's been assigned 20.5. Actually, now these are the IPs that were assigned from the pool that we created. And once you do it on your computer, you should also be able now to have internet access, because if you remember, we NATed this range of IP. We actually NATed the whole range. So we can actually also come to our command prompt here. Yep, open that. Then ping and see if we have internet connection. Yeah, we are good. Then we can also do an IP config to see what IP that we've been assigned. Yeah, here it is. You see this? 172.10.20.5. And when you come here, here we are. So guys, that's how you can be able to set up VPN. And the same way PPTP works is the same way SSTP will also work. So it's basically set up the same way, and that's how you can be able to reach your routers. So guys, make sure to leave a like, subscribe to my channel guys, so that we can build up this community. We are going to be doing a lot of Mikrotik and Ubiquiti network setups. And also, if you'd also want to have a bandwidth management system, I'd explained it in one of my first videos. It's a really nice piece of software. It's called ExitNet, and it's a software that you can use to bill and manage your clients. So thanks guys, make sure to leave a comment and subscribe. See you in the next video. Thank you.